Here our task is to write down an equivalent LCFRS which is ordered. Or another task, you may also read their non-permuting or their monotone. And what this means is, for example, let's look at the first rule. In the left-hand side, we have those variables z, y, x, w. So let's say they are 1, 2, 3, 4. That's the order they have in the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, in the A, we have W, Y, so we have the variable number 4 and the variable number 2. And in B, we have X and Z. And X has numbers, is at place 3 and Z is at place 1. And this makes parsing more complicated. Because if you, for example, know this is the first variable and your LCFS would be ordered, you would only need to look at the first positions. But now that the LCFS is not ordered, you have to look everywhere to find the right set. So now we want to make this one ordered. And this is how we do it. We will change all the rules. So we are now writing superscripts to each non-terminal indicating the order of its positions. So this rule now will become S with superscript 1. So that means we only have one argument here and it's, well, we don't have a new order for it. So nothing really changes, but this matches the format of the other non-terminals. So the left-hand side we keep the same, z, y, x, w. But now on the right-hand side we want to have them ordered. So that means instead of A having w, y, we want to have A, y, w. So we want to have the A, but we are now indicating that we swapped places. So if you just look at the arguments of A, here they have been, or I write it here because here's more space. So this was previous my argument number 1, and this was my argument number 2, and with respect to that A. And now we want to swap some places, so our new A here is called 2, 1. And the variables are Y and W. And, well, we need to write this down because the computer is stupid. And just because we swapped variables doesn't mean the computer knows that we swapped them, because for the computer it doesn't matter how the variables are called. So we want to distinguish this A from with swapped positions from another A where we might not have switched positions. So what we need to do the same for B. So this was previously argument number 1 and this was 2. And now to have them in the same order as they are on the left hand side, they have to swap places. And this B is now called 2, 1, indicating that they were swapped. So, and the arguments are now containing Z and X. So, then let's see at the next rule, we have those A. Let's take another color for this. So we have those A rule, and for this part we need an A with swapped places. So we need a new rule, A with 2, 1, so that we know the A have now swapped places. And now we also have to swap those variables, because if you look at this, then here those A may appear If we only have one recursion, it would appear at the W position. And now the W is here, so we also have to swap arguments here. So now the B is at the left position and the A is on the right, or to say the A is now in the second argument. And the epsilon remains. So let's have a look at the next rule. Let's take, for example, this color. So for this rule, we also now need some swapped. So I wrote down a new rule with 2 and 1. And now here the arguments have swapped, so they are now by and ax. And now at the right hand side, this is now interesting because, well, in the first recursion, we would write them down like they are here. So, and this is actually an A where the places have not been swapped. So this would be an A with 1 and 2 in it. So, and here the positions are called Y and X. So now we have this interesting case. Well, there can be several possibilities. Now, I don't need to swap them here as long as they are in the right order as the left one are. Now they accidentally are in the right order because I swapped them in the left position. But if they would have the wrong order after swapping the first argument, then I would have to swap them again and then write other superscripts. I hope I could make it a little bit clear. But now here I use an A where the arguments were not swapped, and that means for this A, well, this is color different enough. I can use another one. So for this A, where I did not swap positions, I need another rule like this, where the arguments are not swapped. So there's 1 and 2. And the arguments are the same as here. So for this A, I need a rule like this one. And the right-hand side is empty. So that also means ordering makes the parsing process easier, but it also might increase the size of the LCFIS. So, and then the last thing is we have to do is we have now this rule, and we need a rule where the B has been swapped, where the arguments of the B have been swapped. So this is for where the arguments have the order 2 and 1. And C and D now must be swapped. D and C, and the right hand side is empty. And now we not really have our LCFRS. We only have the rules. I would need to write down to be really correct, I would need to write down the definition, and I would need to include all the new non-terminals in the set, but I can leave those exercises for you. And now these are my rules of a new equivalent ordered LCFRS.